Would you like to get the exact strategies that a financial advisor, high net worth financial advisor, uses to lower the risk in his client's portfolio? That's what I'm going to be sharing with you in this video. Hi, I'm Camille Gaines. I write about second half of life, wealth building, and income strategies ahead of retirement or maybe during retirement at retirecertain.com. I share here what I've learned from over 30 years of personally investing my own money, and I'm a bit of a nerd around this. So recently I was reading my Barron's by the pool, and I saw a great article that was an interview with a financial advisor named Andrew Schultz, and he manages over $1 billion. So he's got to be pretty smart guy, right? And he's at Morgan Stanley, and I want to share with you what he said and the strategies that he has in place for his high net worth clients. Now, his typical client portfolio is about $10 million. So this is pretty valuable information, and he's got five different strategies that he uses that you typically don't hear of. And I love seeing a financial advisor that's more strategic and more tactical, that's looking way beyond just the buy and hold. And my dad told me a really long time ago, my dad influenced my investing and he loved investing himself. And he told me a long time ago, look to see what the most successful wealth managers and fund managers and wealth advisors are doing and get ideas for yourself. And back then it was Peter Lynch, but I've always remembered that. And so I love seeing financial advisors that are doing something a little more strategic. And so I'm going to share that with you here and in this video. Now, what this advisor is doing, because he feels like there are three things that have led him to really having these alternative strategies for his clients. And what he said is that, and of course, I've talked about these things here as well. Right now, you simply can't get enough income from traditional investments in stocks and bonds. If you're overweighted in equities, meaning you've got a lot of your money tied up in stocks, you have too much risk, especially if you're nearing retirement. And then the third thing that was mentioned by Schultz in this article is that stocks and bonds often move in the same direction, whereas bonds are supposed to be a little bit of a hedge, keep you a little bit safe when the market goes down, stock market goes down. That doesn't always happen. So for that reason, he has divided his client's money. He puts 50% into a little more traditional investing, stocks and bonds, and then he puts 50% of his client's money into five different alternative strategies. And of course, he has some money in cash as well. But 50% goes into these five different investment strategies, and he divides it 20% in each one. And these different investment strategies, and I need to glance at my notes to make sure I get everything exactly correct. The first one is tactical equity funds. And with this investment strategy, it moves money from one asset class to another. Now, the goal of this is to quickly make money. It's like for a quick gain, and it's a tactical strategy, and the money can be made by moving from one sector or type of investment to another when things rotate based on things that are happening either in the economy or politically or globally. And so that is the goal of that particular strategy. That's tactical equity funds. And let me mention that I normally talk about things here that I've done or I'm extremely familiar with. I'm not doing any of these particular strategies exactly now, but I have researched them and have invested in a couple of these different strategies in the past. The next type of fund he uses, or type of strategy, I should say, investment strategy, is the opportunistic distressed debt. Now, that's just like it sounds. He buys higher risk debt, and of course, higher risk debt is going to pay a higher income level than, treasury bonds, for example, and they're also typically going to be selling cheaply. All right. And then the third area he invests is called absolute return market neutral investing. And with that type of investment, It seeks to have a consistent return, but it doesn't have fluctuation. If the market's moving up and down, it stays neutral, and there's a certain strategy that allows this to happen. And then commodities or managed futures is the next way that he invests, the next strategy, investment strategy he uses. And with that, it's simply buying futures contracts that are typically tied to something like agriculture or gold, oil, commodities, something that moves counter to stock markets. And so that gives investors a little bit more protection. The next strategy is long short equity. And with long short equity, the goal is to simply invest or go long buy stocks that are expected to move up in value and sell stocks that are expected to move down in value. So that would involve short selling and going long. So those are some pretty complex strategies, right? But I love to find financial professionals that are doing something a little more tactical, a little more different than just simply the asset allocation. You got to put this much money in stocks, this much in bonds, this much in cash, based on how old you are. And that simply is not working for a lot of people that are over 50, that are nearing retirement, and they or for people that want to retire early and do something a little more strategically. Now, the article had a couple of funds for that individual investors can use to implement some of these strategies. I've written about that in my article at retirecertain.com, along with some other ideas to implement lower risk investment strategies. And that's what I wanted to share with you in this video. Be sure to come see me at retirecertain.com. And if you'd like the rest of the article, it's all there. And I appreciate your watching.